navzájom.
Because I believe we're all here because we love Jesus.
A verím tomu, že sme tu všetci, lebo milujeme Pána Ježiša.
And even if we don't know each other that well,
a aj keď sa možno nepoznáme ešte až tak dobre,
we're going to be spending a lot of time together in the future.
Tak budeme veľa času tráviť spolu v budúcnosti.
You know, in eternity, right?
Vo večnosti.
So we might as well get to know each other a little bit now.
Tak by sme sa mohli spoznať trošičku teraz.
And be a blessing to one another in the present.
A nejakým spôsobom si byť požehnaním.
But we're going to do this. We're going to get to get to the teaching.
A pôjdeme do vyučovania Božieho slova.
Let's pray.
Tak poďme.
Lord, we just want to invite you to this place.
Pane, my ťa chceme pozvať na toto miesto.
We know that you are present, but we want to say that you're welcome as well.
Pane, my si uvedomujeme, že ty si tu prítomný, ale chceme ti povedať, že si tu vítaný.
And Lord, we know that you do things, you're active, you're the living God.
A Pane, že ty robíš veci a že si aktívny, že si živý Boh.
Lord, you have a purpose, you have a will, you have a direction.
Že máš cieľ, máš zameranie a máš smer, ktorým ideš.
And Lord, so often we are just ignorant, we're blind to seeing what you are doing.
A tak častokrát ignorujeme to, čo ty robíš, a sme slepí a nevidíme, kam máš namierené.
And Lord, I just ask right now that you'd open our hearts by your spirit.
A tak ťa, Pane, teraz prosím, aby si otvoril naše srdcia skrze svojho Ducha Svätého.
You'd open our hearts to your word.
Aby si otvoril naše srdcia k tvojmu slovu.
Lord, that you would not just give us more information, Lord, but you'd give us more life.
Aby si nám nedal len viacej informácií, Pane, ale aby si nám dal viacej zo svojho života.
Lord, that we would step one step closer into your kingdom.
Aby sme boli ešte o krôček bližšie k tvojmu kráľovstvu.
Lord, so we just give you space to speak.
A tak ti dávame, Pane, priestor, aby ty si prehovaral.
Give you space to do something and help us to see what you're doing.
A aby sme ti dávali priestor, aby ty si niečo robil a aby ty si nám pomohol, aby sme aj videli, čo robíš.
And we just want to bless you in this time.
A chceme ti žehnať, Pane, počas tohto obdobia.
And we know that we are blessed by you.
A uvedomujeme si, že budeme tebou požehnaní.
And so we pray these things in your wonderful name.
A všetko toto sa modlíme v tvojom úžasnom mene.
Amen.
Amen.
So earlier Benson was talking, kind of just mentioning, you know, reminding us of where we've been in the year and where we might like to be.
A na začiatku Benson hovoril, alebo nám pripomínal, že kde sme boli tento rok a cez čo všetko sme si prešli. A možno taká vízia do toho budúceho roka, že kam by sme chceli to dotiahnuť, alebo čo by sme chceli robiť.
You know, and this is our last Sunday before moving into 2020.
A toto je naša posledná nedeľa pred tým, ako pôjdeme do roku 2020.
And I don't know about you, but some people, you know, when we get to the end of the year, we're thinking, you know, we're, yes, this is great, I've got this new chance to start some new things.
A keď prichádzame ku koncu roka, tak niektorí ľudia si myslia, že toto je super, že teraz sa niečo končí a mám šancu začať niečo nové.
That's one hand, right?
A to je jeden pohľad.
But on the other hand, there's a lot of unknowns, right?
Ale na druhej strane je tam mnoho takého nepoznaného.
You know, we have no idea what's going to happen in the next few days. We have no idea what's going to happen in the next years.
A nemáme ani poňatia o tom, čo sa stane ďalší deň, alebo čo sa stane ďalší rok, a ďalšie dni, ktoré prichádzajú.
We don't know are we going to be employed, or how's our health, how's our marriages, how's our relationships going to be.
Nevieme, aké bude naše zdravie, či budeme zamestnaní, či budeme nezamestnaní, aké bude naše manželstvo, aké budú naše vzťahy s ľuďmi.
We can make guesses, but we really don't know.
A môžeme si niečo predstaviť a niečo možno odhadnúť, ale v skutočnosti nevieme, čo sa udeje.
And sometimes that can bring fear into our life.
A niekedy toto môže priniesť strach do našich životov.
And it may not even be a fear that we recognize.
A možno to je taký strach, ktorý si ani neuvedomujeme alebo nespoznávame ho.
But it's somewhere in the back of our mind.
Ale je to niekde vzadu v našej mysli.
Somewhere deep in our heart.
Niekde hlboko v našich srdciach.
And that fear begins to affect how we do life.
A tento strach môže ovplyvňovať to, ako žijeme naše životy.
And the Spirit might be speaking, but we are holding back.
A Duch Svätý môže k nám prehovárať, ale my sa tak zdržiavame.
Because of that fear of what might be.
Kvôli tomu strachu, že čo sa môže stať, čo sa môže udiať.
And how we want to protect our little kingdoms.
A ako si my chceme uchrániť to naše maličké kráľovstvo.
Instead of just walking boldly into his kingdom.
Namiesto toho, aby sme odvážne kráčali smerom k jeho kráľovstvu.
Now we have this expression we were talking about it yesterday when we were hiking.
My máme v angličtine jeden taký výraz a včera keď sme boli na prechádzke, tak sme sa o tom rozprávali.
That 2020 is this we say, you know, if you have 20/20 vision, then it means you have clear vision. You can see clearly. You can see well.
V angličtine majú výraz, že ak tvoj zrak alebo tvoja vízia je 20/20, tak máš proste ostrý zrak, že všetko úplne jasne vidíš. Neviem, či to máme aj v slovenčine.
Right. And the only person who has 20/20 vision for the future is Jesus, is God.
A jediný, kto má takýto ostrý zrak a vidí tú budúcnosť takto jasne, je Boh, je Pán Ježiš.
You know, we don't have it, but God does.
My nemáme takýto jasný náhľad na budúcnosť, ale Boh má.
But we're told, the Apostle Paul tells us,
Apoštol Pavol nám hovorí,
says, you know, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has guessed.
Ani oko nevidelo, ani ucho nepočulo, ani na myseľ človeku neprišlo.
The amazing, the incredible, the wonderful things that God has prepared for those who love him.
Všetky tie úžasné veci, ktoré Pán Boh pripravil pre tých, ktorí ho milujú.
So basically God's got these great plans.
Pán Boh má úžasné plány.
And nothing in our natural senses can figure it out.
A nič z toho nášho prirodzeného na to nedokáže prísť, že čo to je.
But then Paul goes on.
Ale potom Pavol pokračuje.
He says, but these things God has revealed to us by his spirit.
A hovorí, že tieto všetky veci nám Pán Boh zjavil skrze svojho ducha.
By his spirit.
Skrze svojho ducha.
And if you want to read more, there's a whole bunch of other things he says about that. It's in 1 Corinthians chapter 2.
A ak by ste si chceli o tom viac prečítať, tak si to môžete nalistovať v 1. liste Korinským 2. kapitole.
But I love this. God knows the future.
Ale mne sa to veľmi páči. A Pán Boh pozná budúcnosť.
And he doesn't just know it, he's planned it.
A nie len ju pozná, ale on ju aj naplánoval.
He's got a special plan for those who love him.
A má úžasný plán aj pre tých, ktorí ho milujú.
And he doesn't want to hide that plan, he actually wants to reveal that plan to us.
A nechce nám schovávať nejako tento svoj plán, ale chce nám ho zjaviť.
And so what I want to do today, we've been going and we're going to continue to go.
A čo budeme dnes robiť? Už sme si prechádzali, ale pôjdeme ďalej v tom, čo sme doteraz riešili, hovorili.
Through the life of Jesus.
Budeme hovoriť o živote Pána Ježiša.
We're still kind of in the what we might call the Christmas story.
A stále sa ako keby nachádzame ešte v takomto vianočnom období a príbehu.
But I want to focus on one thing.
Ale dnes by som sa chcel zamerať na jednu vec.
This idea of prophecy, okay?
A myšlienka proroctva.
Because prophecy is super important.
Lebo proroctvo je veľmi dôležité.
It's where God by his spirit speaks to a person.
Je to niečo, kde Pán Boh skrze nejakého človeka prehovára skrze svojho Ducha Svätého.
To do something mainly for his people.
A aby vykonal niečo hlavne pre svoj ľud.
But not only.
Ale nie len pre svoj ľud.
It's something that is, it's all through the Bible.
Je to zaznamenané v Biblii.
It's important in the church.
Je to dôležité aj pre cirkev.
But sometimes we're avoiding it.
Ale niekedy sa ako keby vyhýbame proroctvu.
So, we're going to go talk about prophecy today a little bit.
Čiže dnes budeme hovoriť o proroctve.
About God revealing things to us.
O tom, ako Pán Boh nám zjavuje veci.
And I don't know about you, because there's different feelings about prophecy.
Neviem ako vy, lebo sú rôzne názory, čo sa týka proroctva.
You know, I've met some people who, you know, claim to be prophets.
A stretol som nejakých ľudí, ktorí tvrdia o sebe, že sú proroci.
And they're very vocal about that claim.
A sú dosť aj zvuční, čo sa týka tohto prehlasovania.
And then I hear what they're saying and I'm like, I'm not so sure.
A potom sa započúvam do toho, čo hovoria, a si tak hovorím, že tak nie som si až tak veľmi istý.
And then I meet some other people.
A potom sa stretnem s nejakými inými ľuďmi.
Sometimes they know they have that gift, sometimes they don't.
A niekedy vedia, že majú tento dar, a niekedy aj nevedia, že majú tento dar.
But it's clear that God is speaking through them.
Ale je jasné, že Pán Boh skrze nich prehovára.
So, I want to talk about prophecy really simply.
Chcem hovoriť o proroctve veľmi jednoducho.
You know, what is it?
Čo to je?
There's two ways we can look at it, very simple ways.
Sú dva spôsoby, ako by sme sa mohli na proroctvo pozrieť, sú jednoduché.
You see it in the Bible. One is that God foretells.
Jeden spôsob je, že Pán Boh predpovedá.
You know, he tells, he basically gives his opinion about something.
že dáva svoj názor a svoje myšlienky o niečom.
You see it many times in the Old Testament when God is confronting his people about sin.
A mnohokrát v starej zmluve, keď Pán Boh karhal svoj ľud, keď sa čo sa týkalo hriechu.
He would send the prophet and the prophet would just say, "Wake up guys, you're on the wrong path. Get back to God."
A posielal prorokov a hovoril im, že zobuďte sa, ste na zlej ceste, musíte sa prinavrátiť naspäť.
And then the other aspect is this foretelling where God basically shares his plans.
A druhý aspekt je prehlasovanie niečoho, kde nám hovorí niečo, čo sa bude diať.
Where he lets us in on what he's gonna do.
Niečo, čo plánuje spraviť.
And we see that these two things should be operating in the church.
A tieto dve veci by mali fungovať aj v cirkvi.
Because Paul, the apostle, says it should.
Alebo Pavol apoštol hovorí, že by to malo takto fungovať.
He tells the church in Corinth who were doing it kind of wrong. He says this is how you do it right.
A hovorí nám, že robili ste toto zle a takýmto spôsobom by ste to mali robiť dobre.
And I love how Paul describes prophecy.
A mne sa páči, ako Pavol opisuje proroctvo.
Or the ministry of prophecy.
Alebo službu proroctva.
It's in 1 Corinthians chapter 14 verse 3.
1. Korinským 14:3.
It says the one who prophesies speaks to the people for their strength, for their comfort, and for their encouragement.
Ale kto prorokuje ľuďom, hovorí to, čo buduje, napomína a potešuje.
So prophecy is a really good thing.
Čiže proroctvo je veľmi dobrá vec.
I mean, who doesn't need more strength?
Kto z vás nepotrebuje silu alebo pozbudenie?
Who doesn't need more encouragement?
Kto nepotrebuje pozbudenie?
Who doesn't need more comfort of the Spirit?
Kto nepotrebuje potešenie od Ducha Svätého?
We all need that.
Každý z nás to potrebujeme.
We all should be like, yeah, I want more prophecy spoken over me.
Každý z nás by mal byť, áno, chcem viacej proroctva do môjho života.
You know, I need more of that.
Ja potrebujem toho viacej.
Right. And now we're going to move to the story. We're going to look in Luke chapter 1.
A my sa teraz pozrieme na ten príbeh hlavný, ktorý budeme dnes rozoberať. Je to v Lukášovi v 1. kapitole.
Now, Luke is, he's kind of writing prophetically.
Lukáš písal prorockým spôsobom.
He's not just writing out of his own mind.
Nepísal niečo, čo si len on sám vymyslel.
But the Spirit is guiding him.
Ale Duch ho viedol.
Now, he is still Luke.
On je stále Lukášom.
You know, we see his style of writing and his thought patterns and stuff like that.
Vidíme štýl, akým písal, alebo myšlienkové pochody.
But we know it's the Spirit working through him.
Ale vieme, že to bol Duch Svätý, ktorý pracoval skrze neho.
And I love how he starts his gospel or the gospel of Jesus according to him.
A mne sa veľmi páči, ako začína evanjelium podľa neho, ako to on napísal.
And I just want to read the first four verses.
Prvé 4 verše z prvej kapitoly vám prečítam.
It says many have undertaken to draw an account of the things that have been fulfilled among us, just as they were handed down to us by those who were first were eyewitnesses and servants of the word. With this in mind, since I myself carefully investigated everything from the beginning, I too decided to write an orderly account for you, most excellent Theophilus, so that you may know with certainty the things that you have been taught.
Keďže sa mnohí pokúšali rád radom vyrozprávať udalosti, ktoré sa u nás stali, ako nám ich aj podali tí, čo od počiatku boli očitými svedkami a stali sa služobníkmi slova. Aj ja, ktorý som všetko znova dôkladne zistil, rozhodol som sa, vznešený Teofil, napísať ti to rád radom, aby si poznal spoľahlivosť rečí, ktorým ťa vyučovali.
I like how he writes this.
Mne sa páči, ako to napísal.
He says, I want to write some things that have been fulfilled.
A hovorí tu, že ja chcem napísať niečo, čo už sa splnilo.
Not just what have happened, but things that have been fulfilled.
Nie to, čo sa stalo, ale to, čo sa splnilo.
And he writes this guy Theophilus.
A píše tomuto človeku Teofilovi.
And we spoke about this a few weeks ago, but we'll say it again.
A hovorili sme o tom pred pár týždňami, ale spomeniem to znovu.
You know, Theophilus means lover of God.
Teofil znamená milovaný Bohom alebo ten, ktorý miluje Boha.
And I think that we're all lovers of God here, right?
A dúfam, že všetci sme tu milujúci Boha.
So this letter is for us.
A tento list alebo toto evanjelium je aj pre nás.
Right? Just think of it, he's writing this for you.
A zamyslite sa nad tým tak, že toto on píše pre teba.
And he's writing that some things have been fulfilled.
A hovorí nám, že tieto veci už boli splnené.
And I'm writing these down, I want you to know them.
A chcem, aby si ich vedel, preto ich píšem.
So that you will have certainty, you will have confidence.
Aby si poznal spoľahlivosť, aby si bol ubezpečený.
So it won't just be like, yeah, I kind of believe, but no, I confidently believe.
Aby to nebolo len také, že áno, verím niečomu, ale nie, ja som presvedčený, viem s určitosťou.
And because I have a time limit, we're not going to go into the greater details. There's so many details, you know.
Keďže tu sme časovo obmedzení, tak nepôjdem do všetkých tých detailov.
But I'm just thinking, you know, how does prophecy build confidence?
A ja som sa zamýšľal nad tým, že ako proroctvo buduje takú spoľahlivosť, alebo že sme si istí niečím.
How do things being fulfilled bring confidence to our faith?
Ako to, že sa niečo, čo bolo prorokované, keď sa to splní, ako nás to zbuduje do takej spoľahlivosti alebo do takého utvrdenia?
And I think especially when God foretells something, when he tells his plans that they're going to happen and they come true.
A hlavne je to vtedy, keď Pán Boh nám predpovedá svoje plány, hovorí nám o niečom, čo plánuje a potom sa to splní.
That brings a certain confidence.
Tak to, v tom sme takí uistení.
Because when we see when he predicts things.
Lebo keď vidíme, že niečo predpovedá,
he predicts things in a way that just these crazy combinations that just couldn't happen unless God was doing it.
Tak to robí takým spôsobom, že sú to úplne bláznivé, divoké kombinácie, ktoré same od seba by sa nikdy nesplnili, ak by to nebol len Pán Boh, ten, ktorý ich zorganizoval.
Right? And you know, like, if it's not God, it's not happening.
Asi vtedy uvedomuje, že ak to nebol Boh, tak to sa nemohlo udiať same od seba.
I mean, even I just give a small personal testimony.
Ja vám dám osobné svedectvo.
And some of, you know, if you've been here for a while, you've heard this one already.
A ak ste tu už niekoľko rokov, tak ste počuli.
You know, this building that we're sitting in right now.
A tieto priestory, v ktorých sa nachádzame.
You know, before, and Eric, you remember the days.
A Eric si pamätá, keď sme ešte boli predtým.
Where we were meeting in a little place that was like not even as big as the space on this side of the arch.
Tak sme sa stretávali v takých priestoroch, ktoré boli ešte menšie ako táto časť, čo je tuto za tým oblúkom.
It's a really small little room in a basement.
Úplne malinké priestory niekde v pivnici.
And it wasn't big enough.
A nestačilo nám to, nebolo to dosť veľké.
And the Lord says really clearly, hey, we need to move out of this space.
A Pán Boh povedal veľmi jasne, že musíme sa presťahovať z tohto priestoru.
But we need to, you know, and you're going to be moving somewhere in the center.
A budete niekde v centre.
And you know, we looked around.
A hľadali sme.
And the prices are really, really expensive.
A ceny sú dosť vysoké.
You know, and we're like, in the natural, it doesn't work.
A prirodzeným spôsobom to proste nefungovalo.
Because either no one wants to rent to us,
buď nám nikto nechcel prenajať priestory,
or we couldn't even do one Sunday, you know?
A nemohli by sme ani len jednu nedeľu do mesiaca sa stretávať.
Impossible, right?
Nemožné.
And you know, we just prayed.
Tak sme sa modlili.
And we prayed, Lord, we know that you want to have us here.
A modlili sme sa takto, že Pane, vieme, že chceš, aby sme boli niekde v centre.
And so we know it's from you.
A aby sme vedeli, že to bude od teba.
Can you give it to us for free?
Tak nám to daj zadarmo.
Can you give it to us for free?
Daj nám to zadarmo.
About a week later, God answers the prayer.
A asi o týždeň na to Pán Boh odpovedal na tú modlitbu.
And you're in this space.
A ste v tých priestoroch.
And we get it every week for free.
A každý týždeň to máme zadarmo.
You know, we're 50 meters from the very center of Bratislava.
Sme 50 metrov od toho úplného centra Bratislavy.
The only way he could more better fulfill that is if he gives us the president's palace.
A ešte lepšie, ako by to mohol Pán Boh splniť, by bolo, keby nám dal prezidentský palác.
And we're open to that.
Aj voči tomu sme otvorení.
Right?
Benson, not this way, this way.
But, you know, God told us something.
Pán Boh nám niečo povedal.
And it's crazy.
A je to divoké.
You know, but he fulfilled it.
Ale on to splnil.
And that brings me confidence.
A z toho som ja pozbudený.
You know, there's days where I don't want to do what I'm doing.
A sú dni, kedy proste nechcem robiť to, čo robím.
You know, and I'm like, you know, you're scratching your head wondering, what am I doing here?
A tak sa škrabeš po hlave, že čo tu vlastne robím?
And God reminds me, he's like, no, I put you here.
A Pán Boh mi pripomína, ja som ten, ktorý som ťa tu zasadil.
I fulfilled those promises. As I gave to you.
Ja som ti splnil tie zasľúbenia, ktoré som ti dal.
So you keep being obedient.
Tak ty buď poslušný.
And you just keep waiting for the next direction.
A čakaj na ďalšie pokyny.
And I'm going to fulfill that too.
A potom ti aj tie splním.
And that brings a confidence.
A toto ma tak utvrdzuje.
Now, so anyways, Luke is saying there's been some things that have been fulfilled and brings a confidence.
Čiže boli veci, ktoré sa splnili, a tieto veci sú spoľahlivé.
Now today we can't go through all the prophecies about Jesus.
A dnes nestíhame si prejsť všetky proroctvá, čo sa týkajú Pána Ježiša.
Depends on who you ask, but there's about 324 plus or minus messianic prophecies in the Old Testament.
Záleží, koho by ste sa spýtali, ale je zhruba okolo 325 proroctiev, či už plus alebo minus, mesiánskych proroctiev o Pánovi Ježišovi.
Things that God has clearly said through the prophets that tell us about Christ to come.
A veci, ktoré nám Pán Boh povedal o Pánovi Ježišovi, o Mesiášovi, ktoré sa mali stať a potom sa aj stali.
And I was just trying to think about this when 342 prophecies.
Keď 342 proroctiev je.
You know, we have these combinations locks on some of our boxes here.
A máme tu tieto krabice a máme tam zámok, ktorým to uzamykame a je tam nejaká kombinácia čísiel.
And there's three numbers we have to put in.
A sú tam tri čísla, ktoré musíme dať.
You know, and I don't know according to mathematics how many probable numbers there could be.
A neviem z matematického hľadiska, že koľko tých kombinácií by tam mohlo byť.
Yeah, no, I guess.
999, yeah. Dobre, so, máme tu niekoho.
Now, if you remember if you have a lock that would have 342.
A keby ste mali zámok, ktorý mal 342 nejakých čísel.
And you would have to do it all perfectly. Right?
A všetky tie čísla by si musel zosúradiť tak perfektne.
Right, for that to happen.
Aby sa to udialo.
None of us are getting into the box, guys.
Tak nikto z nás by sme sa nedostali do tej krabice.
All right. For one person,
aby jedna osoba,
to fulfill this crazy combination,
splnila všetky tieto proroctvá, všetky tieto kombinácie týchto proroctiev.
Unless it was God, it's impossible.
A ak by to nebolo od Boha, tak je to nemožné.
And we're going to just look at one simple one and we're just going to look at it really briefly.
Pozrieme si jedno to proroctvo veľmi stručne.
And it's just the place of his birth.
A je to miesto, kde sa narodil.
Now in Matthew's gospel,
Matúšovom evanjeliu,
you remember the story where the magi come?
Pamätáte si ten príbeh, kde prichádzajú mudrci?
You know, they followed the star.
Nasledovali hviezdu.
They're looking for the king to be born and of course where do they go? They go to the palace.
A hľadali kráľa, ktorý sa narodil, a kde inde by mali ísť ako do paláca?
And they ask Herod, you know, where is this king?
A pýtali sa Herodesa, že kde je toto babetko, čo sa malo narodiť, kde je tento kráľ?
And in Matthew 2 we see that Herod, he's kind of disturbed because he doesn't know what he's talking about.
A vidíme, že Herodes sa trošku rozrušil, lebo nevedel, o čom hovoria.
Jerusalem is disturbed.
A celý Jeruzalém sa vzrušil.
And so what he does is he's going to call all the priests and all the leaders of the country.
A povolal si všetkých kňazov a všetkých vodcov, všetkých mudrcov zo svojej krajiny.
He's going to get the lawyers, the readers of the law.
A povolal si právnikov a všetkých tých zákonodarcov, alebo čo čítali zákon, Boží zákon.
And he asks, where is the baby? Where is the Messiah to be born?
A pýtal sa ich, že odkiaľ má prísť toto babetko, kde sa má narodiť Mesiáš?
And these guys, they know instantly.
A všetci títo hneď vedeli.
And they quote the prophet Micah.
A citujú proroka Micha.
And you can read it yourself in Micah chapter 5.
Micha 5.
And they say, in Bethlehem, Judea, they reply.
Betlehemskej, alebo v Judsku, v Betleheme.
For this is what the prophet has written. But you in Bethlehem, the land of Judah.
Lebo toto písal prorok. Ale z teba, Betlehem, z krajiny Júda.
Are by no means least amongst the rulers of Judah.
Nie si o nič menší medzi všetkými vodcami v Judsku.
For out of you will come a ruler who will be a shepherd of my people Israel.
Lebo z teba vyjde vodca alebo pastier, ktorý mi bude pastierom môjho ľudu Izraela.
So all these religious guys, they knew about this prophecy.
Všetci títo náboženskí vodcovia vedeli o tomto proroctve.
Now this prophecy was spoken about 700 years prior.
Toto proroctvo bolo vyslovené asi 700 rokov pred tým, ako sa udialo.
Roughly, okay?
Zhruba.
You know, so this was an old prophecy. People had been thinking about it, looking for it, anticipating it for at least 700 years.
A ľudia si ho čítali, rozímali nad ním a vedeli o ňom asi 700 rokov.
And then we pick up in Luke's story, we jump back to the Gospel of Luke.
A keď sa vrátime naspäť k Lukášovi,
Luke chapter 2, we see the fulfillment of this prophecy.
Lukáš 2, tak tam vidíme naplnenie tohto proroctva.
I'm going to read verses 1 through 7.
Od 1. po 7. verš si prečítame.
And you probably heard this many times at Christmas time.
A mnohokrát počas Vianoc ste počuli pravdepodobne tento príbeh.
It says, in the days Caesar's Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place during Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David, and he went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. And there, while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn.
V tých dňoch vyšiel rozkaz od cisára Augusta popísať celý svet. Tento prvý popis bol vtedy, keď sýrskym vladárom bol Kyrenios. Išli preto všetci, aby sa dali zapísať každý do svojho mesta. Vybral sa teda aj Jozef z Galilei, z mesta Nazareta, do Judska, do mesta Dávidovho, ktoré sa volá Betlehem. Pretože bol z domu a z rodu Dávidovho, aby sa dal zapísať so svojou snúbenicou Máriou, ktorá bola v požehnanom stave. Keď tam došli, naplnili sa dni, aby porodila. I porodila svojho prvorodeného syna, obvinula ho plienkami a uložila v jasliach, lebo v nocľahárni pre nich nebolo miesto.
I don't want to go too deep into this, okay?
Nepôjdeme veľmi hlboko do tohto.
But we see there was a prophecy.
Ale vidíme, že bolo proroctvo.
And it's fulfilled.
A je naplnené.
Plain and simple. Okay?
Je to veľmi jednoduché.
And it just what I got from this is just God has a plan.
A čo ja som si z tohto zobral, bolo, že Pán Boh má plán.
And not only is a plan, it's a divine setup, okay?
A nie je to len obyčajný plán, ale je to nadprirodzené preplánovanie.
He has intentions and he has purposes. He has a will on in heaven that will be manifested here on earth.
A on má ciele a zámery a svoju vôľu, ktorá je spravená síce v nebi, ale bude aplikovaná tu na zemi.
And for whatever reason, he chose that Jesus was going to be born in Bethlehem.
A z akéhokoľvek dôvodu si vybral, že Pán Ježiš sa má narodiť v Betleheme.
We can speculate about that, why, but that's not so important as that he chose that place.
A môžeme špekulovať, že prečo si vybral práve toto miesto, ale vybral si ho.
And he gave people 700 years to just kind of think about that.
A dal ľuďom 700 rokov zhruba, aby sa nad tým zamýšľali.
And that he would fulfill that.
A potom im to splnil.
Right? And he would want that to happen so much.
A chcel, aby sa to stalo až tak veľmi.
You know, he chose this little girl from Nazareth.
Vybral si mladé dievča z Nazareta.
Mary, right?
Mária.
Who just happens to fall in love with Joseph.
Ktorá sa zhodou okolností zamilovala do Jozefa.
Who just happens to be from the line of David.
Ktorý zhodou okolností je z toho kmeňa Dávidovho.
And thousands of kilometers elsewhere.
A je tisícky kilometrov niekde inde.
He'll move Caesar's heart.
Posunie cisárovo srdce.
And move a whole empire.
A presunie celé impérium.
To have this census.
Aby mali toto spočítanie ľudu.
You know, he'll move nations and politics.
A bude hýbať aj národy, aj politiku.
And he'll basically move the world.
A celý svet popohýňa.
Move history.
Popohýňa aj celú históriu.
To get this one thing done.
Aby spravil túto jednu vec.
And this is just one of the many things he's doing.
A to je jedna z vecí, ktoré Boh robí.
One number on the combination.
Jedno to čísielko z tej kombinácie.
And my mind is blown when I think about this, you know?
A moja myseľ to nechápe, keď sa nad tým zamýšľam.
And we're told, for at least from our perspective,
a nám je povedané, teda z nášho pohľadu,
that he does this so that he is one of his tools to build our confidence.
Že toto robí, aby naše ubezpečenie, naša taká dôvera v neho bola zbudovaná.
Our confidence in him.
Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Great.
I already did that.
Wonderful. We have this saying in English, hindsight, looking back on something is 20/20. It's clear.
A v angličtine máme také príslovie, že keď sa pozeráš už na to, čo sa stalo, tak tam máš tú víziu tých 20/20, že to už ti je úplne jasné, to už vieš, čo sa tam udialo.
Right, and we understand that, right? That
a tomu rozumieme, to chápeme.
It's much easier to look back on things and understand things than to look forward.
Lebo je o mnoho jednoduchšie sa pozrieť späť na veci, ktoré sa stali a rozumieť im, ako možno na veci, ktoré sa ešte len majú udiať.
Like we had this situation about 2 months ago.
Pred dvoma mesiacmi sme mali jednu situáciu.
You know, some of us guys were planning to go to Israel.
A niektorí z nás chalanov sme mali naplánované, že pôjdeme do Izraela.
Because we went the year before, we were excited to go again.
Lebo sme išli rok predtým, tak sme sa tešili, že znovu pôjdeme.
And as we're planning, it's not working.
A my ako sme to plánovali, tak proste nič nevychádzalo.
And we get to this point where like, okay, you know what? Doesn't feel like the Lord is in this, you know?
A ako sme sa teda to snažili naplánovať, tak sme si uvedomili, že asi sa nezdá, že Pán Boh v tom je.
And we can push through and we can make this thing happen.
A mohli sme na to tlačiť a mohli sme si dupnúť a povedať, že teda aj tak pôjdeme.
Or we can just kind of be obedient and hold off.
Alebo sme mohli byť poslušní a teda neísť.
And we were obedient, we held off.
A boli sme poslušní, nešli sme.
And it was so cool because like within the next 2 weeks some things happen.
A bolo to také úžasné, lebo v ďalších dvoch týždňoch sa udiali nejaké veci.
Some things that happened in our different personal lives and some things that the Lord was doing.
Nejaké veci, ktoré sa udiali či už v osobných životoch alebo v tom, čo Pán Boh v nás robil.
And then we could look back on that situation.
A potom sme sa mohli pozrieť naspäť na tú situáciu.
And we could look at it with thankfulness.
A mohli sme sa na to pozrieť s vďačnosťou.
So thank you Lord that we didn't go to Israel.
Ďakujeme, Pane, za to, že si nám nedovolil ísť do Izraela.
You know, 'cause it would have been really bad.
Lebo by to bolo veľmi zlé.
Right, the Lord saved us from a few things.
Ale Pán Boh nás zachránil pred nejakými vecami.
But we didn't know it in the moment, right?
Ale v tej chvíli sme si to neuvedomovali.
Right, it's easy to look back on that and understand that, but what if you're looking forward?
A je to veľmi jednoduché, keď sa pozeráš spätne na niečo, vtedy si to uvedomuješ a vtedy to vidíš jasne, ale čo ak sa pozeráš dopredu?
You know, what if you're on the front end of prophecy?
Čo ak si tak na začiatku toho proroctva?
Where it's not fulfilled yet.
Ktoré sa ešte nesplnilo.
And how does that help us now? How does it build our confidence?
Ako nám to pomáha v tej chvíli, teraz a ako nás to zbuduje?
And so we're going to switch perspectives now to not people who are looking back on prophecy, but people who are looking forward.
Čiže teraz sa trošku zmeníme a budeme sa pozerať a budeme mať ten pohľad ľudí, ktorí sú na začiatku toho proroctva, ktorí ešte ho len očakávajú.
And I think there's some ways that prophecy builds our confidence when we're on the front end of it.
A ja si myslím, že proroctvo, aj keď sme len na začiatku toho proroctva, tak nás zbuduje tú takú dôveru a takú odvahu.
And there's three simple ways.
Sú tri jednoduché spôsoby.
Prophecy, it prepares us.
Proroctvo nás pripravuje. You
know, it makes us ready to receive what God is going to do.
Pripravuje nás na to, aby sme prijali, čo Pán Boh chce vykonať.
So that when he does it, we can be good with it. Right?
A keď to teda spraví, keď to naplní Pán Boh, tak my sme s tým v pohode.
Prophecy should also bring peace to us, should bring shalom.
A proroctvo by nám malo priniesť pokoj, šalom.
You know, we be able to rest in the love of God.
Mali by sme byť schopní odpočinúť, spočinúť v Božej láske.
Rest in the goodness of God.
Spočinúť v Božej dobrote.
Rest in the peace of God.
Spočinúť v Božom pokoji.
That we know that whatever's coming is going to be for our good.
Aby sme si uvedomovali, že čokoľvek príde, tak to bude pre naše dobro.
It doesn't mean it's going to be easy.
Neznamená to, že to bude jednoduché.
Doesn't mean it's going to be convenient.
Neznamená to, že to bude výhodné.
But his will is good, pleasing and perfect.
Lebo jeho vôľa je dobrá, je milá a good, pleasing a dokonalá.
That's what the scriptures tell us.
To nám hovorí písmo.
And then the last thing is, it should lead us to praise.
A proroctvo by nás malo viesť do chvály.
That when we go through that prophecy,
že
living it out.
My keď si prežijeme to proroctvo, keď prejdeme cezeň,
in the end we can just worship.
Tak na konci potom budeme schopní uctievať.
We can say, God, yes, thank you.
A budeme vedieť povedať, Pane Bože, áno, ďakujem.
So we're going to look at this account of the in this Christ, kind of Christmas story about some guys who are on the front end of the prophecy.
Čiže my si pozrieme tento ako keby vianočný príbeh a pozrieme sa na ľudí, ktorí boli na začiatku toho proroctva.
So in Luke chapter 2 verse 8.
Lukáš 2. kapitola 8. verš.
We get our characters.
Máme tu našich hrdinov.
So there were some shepherds that were living out in the fields nearby keeping watch over their flocks at night.
A boli v tom kraji pastieri, ktorí nocovali na poli a strážili si v noci stádo.
So these shepherds are just normal guys, working class people.
A títo pastieri boli normálni ľudia, boli to pracujúca vrstva.
People like you and me.
Ľudia takí ako ty a ja.
And they're just out there doing their job, minding their business.
A boli len tam na tom poli a robili si svoju prácu.
It says there are these fields that are nearby.
Je tam napísané, že tam boli polia, ktoré boli na blízku.
There's a lot of fields nearby Bethlehem.
A vedľa Betlehema je veľa polí.
It wasn't a big town, it's still not a big town.
Nebolo to veľké mesto, stále to nie je veľké mesto.
Right. There's some fields, it's still there.
A tieto polia sú ešte stále tam?
And we don't know exactly which fields these guys were in.
Nevieme presne, na ktorých poliach títo muži boli.
But some people, some theologians speculate they were in this area, Migdal Eder, which basically means the tower of the flock.
A niektorí teológovia si myslia, že boli v oblasti Migdal Eder, čo znamená v preklade veža stáda.
And even today we don't know exactly where this place is. We know roughly, but it's just kind of on the edge of Bethlehem.
A ani v dnešnej dobe nevieme presne, kde to bolo, ale niekde na pokraji Betlehema.
So there's these guys are out there, it's nighttime, they're doing their job. They're in this area, this tower of the flock, we believe.
A teda sú tam títo chalani, sú tam títo muži, robili si svoju prácu, je niekde v noci to bolo, pravdepodobne niekde v blízkosti tam, kde bola tá veža, stáda.
And it's interesting, this flock that would have been there.
A toto stádočko, alebo stádo, ktoré sa tam nachádzalo.
It's a tower of the flock, but what flock?
Keďže to mesto sa volalo, alebo to miesto, tá pastvina sa volala, že veža stáda, tak akého stáda? Mm-hmm.
And it would have been the area where there, you know, the sheep that were going to go to Jerusalem for the Passover or other festivals, they would have been raised in this area.
A bolo toto stádo, ktoré využívali, alebo potom z tohto stáda sa brali tie barančeky, či už na paschu, alebo na obete, a tieto barančeky by išli potom do Jeruzalema.
Because Bethlehem and this field, these fields are relatively close. It's only 8 kilometers away.
Lebo tieto pastviny sú asi len 8 kilometrov od Jeruzalema.
But these sheep are not just any sheep, they're these lambs that are raised to be perfect.
A tieto ovečky neboli len hociaké ovečky, ale boli to ovečky, ktoré boli sa starali o nich, aby boli dokonalé, aby boli perfektné.
These are the lambs that are going to go and be put, you know, on the sacrificial altar and they're going to atone for the sins of the people.
A mali to byť ovečky, ktoré boli dané na oltár a boli to zástupné ovečky za obeť všetkého ľudu.
And in here we get another little view on prophecy.
A tu máme ďalší taký náhľad na toto proroctvo.
Another thing it does for us.
Niečo, čo to pre nás robí.
And it basically prophecy foreshadows things.
Proroctvo predpovedá alebo prehlasuje veci pre nás.
It gives us a little bit of a hint to God's intention in his heart.
Dáva nám to taký náznak toho, čo má Pán Boh na srdci.
Now, a lot of people, a lot of theologians have speculated why Bethlehem.
Mnohí teológovia sa zamýšľali nad tým, že a prečo práve Betlehem?
And you know, there's whole books written on this.
A sú o tom napísané celé knihy.
I'll just give you a few things that come to my mind immediately.
A ja vám dám zo pár vecí, ktoré ma hneď len tak napadajú.
Of all the places, why would God choose Bethlehem?
Zo všetkých tých miest, prečo by si Pán Boh práve vybral Betlehem?
He could have chose Jerusalem.
Mohol si vybrať Jeruzalém.
He could have chose Hebron.
Mohol si vybrať Hebron.
He could have chosen Bratislava.
Mohol si vybrať Bratislavu.
He could choose anywhere, right?
Mohol si vybrať hocičo.
But he chooses this really small place.
A vybral si toto maličké miestečko.
And immediately the name itself, Bethlehem, the house of bread.
Keď si preložíte toto slovo Bethlehem, je to dom chleba.
You know, what a perfect place for the Jesus who comes and says, I am the bread of life.
Aké úžasné miesto, kde Pán Ježiš, keď prehlasuje sám o sebe, že ja som chlieb života.
To be born in the house of bread, right?
Aby sa narodil v meste chleba.
Right. We know Bethlehem is the birthplace of King David.
Bethlehem bolo takisto miesto, kde sa narodil aj kráľ Dávid.
You know, and everyone knows that.
A každý toto vedel.
Like if you go to Israel today or you talk to Jewish friends.
Ak by ste išli do Izraela teraz a rozprávali by ste sa so židovskými priateľmi?
You know, you say the name David, my son's David.
A povedali by ste meno David, ja mám Davida.
You know, if we say, hey, this is David.
A povedali by sme, že toto je náš David.
Our friends will say, David, Hamelech.
A naši priatelia by povedali, David, Hamelech.
You know, David the king, right?
David, ten král.
Because, you know, there's this inseparable connection between David and kingship.
Alebo je nerozlučná taká dvojica medzi Dávidom a jeho kráľovaním.
David is the ideal king.
Dávid bol ten ideálny alebo je ideálny kráľ.
You read the you know, first and second Kings and first and second Chronicles, there were a lot of bad kings.
A keď si čítate prvé a druhé kráľov alebo prvé a druhé kronické knihy, tak bolo veľa kráľov a veľa z nich bolo aj zlých.
And every king.
A každý z týchto kráľov.
As you read through those books.
A keď si čítate tieto knihy.
Every king is determine if he's good or bad depending on how does he measure up to David.
Tak každý z týchto kráľov bol porovnávaný a či už bol dobrý alebo zlý, tak to bolo vždy porovnávané k Dávidovi.
David's the test.
David je tá šablonka, ten test.
And so this is his hometown.
A toto bolo domovým mestom Dávidovo.
The ideal king comes from here.
Ideálny kráľ pochádza z takéhoto mesta.
And the king of the universe.
Aj kráľ vesmíru.
Decided I'm going to be born in the place of the ideal king.
A sa rozhodol, že ja sa tiež narodím do toho mesta, z ktorého pochádza tento ideál.
And then just going back to that idea we mentioned a few minutes ago about the Passover lambs.
A keď sme hovorili pred chvíľkou o paschálnych baránkoch.
You know, what better place for Jesus to be born?
Aké ešte lepšie miesto by mohlo byť pre Pána Ježiša, aby sa narodil?
Than the place where the sacrificial lambs would come from.
A ako to miesto, z ktorého pochádzali všetky zábytné baránky.
That's why we see in like for example in John's gospel.
Preto vidíme v Jánovom evanjeliu.
And John the Baptist is out baptizing, right?
A Ján Krstiteľ keď krstil.
And we don't know exactly what he was, how it was.
Nevieme presne ako to bolo.
But I can imagine he bring someone down, you know.
A keď niekoho ponáral.
And then he sees Jesus.
A potom vidí Pána Ježiša.
Hey, that's the Lamb of God.
Hovorí, že, baránok Boží.
Who takes away the sins of the world.
Ktorý sníma hriechy sveta.
Look at this guy.
Pozrite sa na tohto človeka.
The guy in the water.
A človek ešte stále pod vodou.
No, but really, seriously. But, you know, John sees Jesus.
Ale Ján, keď videl Pána Ježiša.
And he declares, hey, this is the Lamb.
A hovorí o ňom, že toto je ten baránok.
This is the one who's going to cover the sins now.
Toto je ten, ktorý prikryje alebo odpustí všetky hriechy, ktorý sníma.
Not just for the Jews.
Nie len pre Židov.
But for everybody.
Ale pre všetkých.
All peoples.
Všetky ľudí, všetky národy.
The world.
Celý svet.
Right? These are some things that are foreshadowed in this birthplace.
Toto sú veci, ktoré sú takým predobrazom v tomto mieste, kde sa Pán Ježiš narodil.
Kind of just pull back the veil and just show us a little bit of God's heart towards us and his plan for us.
Ako keby nám to tak odkrývalo tú oponu a odhaľovalo Boží zámer pre nás.
Things that can, if we remind ourselves, can bring us confidence.
Veci, ktoré keď si ich budeme pripomínať, tak nás budú budovať také uistenie.
I want to go back to the story, okay?
Keď sa vrátime naspäť teda do toho príbehu.
Back to those shepherds is doing their work.
Naspäť tým pastierom, ktorí si robili len svoju prácu.
In verse 9 it says the angel of the Lord appeared to them and the glory of the Lord shone around them and they were terrified.
A hľa, anjel Pánov postavil sa vedľa nich a sláva Pánova ich osvietila i báli sa bázňou veľkou.
Remember, these guys are not necessarily looking for Messiah, or at least not that evening, okay?
A ak si spomínate, tak títo muži nečakali na Mesiáša, alebo teda vôbec ten večer ho neočakávali.
They're just doing their job. They're clocking in, they're doing their job, they're doing what they need to do.
A robili si svoju prácu, prišli, pípli sa v práci, že odteraz som tu a teraz si to budem robiť a nič neočakávali.
They're minding their own business.
A mysleli len na to, čo mali spraviť, vykonať.
And God literally invades their life, right?
A Pán Boh okupoval ako keby ich život, vstúpil do ňoho.
And you know, if you've ever been out in the wilderness.
Ak ste boli niekedy v divočine alebo niekde na púšti?
You know, couple years back when we were driving through the Negev desert in Israel.
A pred pár rokmi my keď sme išli cez púšť Negev v Izraeli.
And we stopped out there.
A zastali sme.
And we just got out and looked at the stars.
A vyšli sme vonku z auta a pozreli sme sa hore na tie hviezdy.
And there's just, you know, it's like more stars than I've seen in my life.
A je to proste tak veľa hviezd, že toľko som v živote nevidel.
Because it's really dark out there.
Lebo je tam hrozne veľká tma.
You know, and I could just imagine, you know, these shepherds are out there, maybe they got the little fire.
A si tak predstavím týchto pastierov, že sú tam vonku, majú možno nejaký malý ohník.
But it's dark.
Ale je tam veľká tma.
And this angel comes.
A prichádza tento anjel.
And we'll see in a minute, he doesn't come by himself.
A vidíme, že neprichádza sám.
He comes with like the armies of the Lord, you know.
A prichádza celou armádou Božou.
You know, thousand, who knows, I don't know how many.
Tisícky, neviem, okay. Veľa.
You ever seen those, you know, alien abduction movies?
Videli ste niekedy tie také filmy, kde prichádza nejaké UFO a idú niekoho uchvátiť?
You know, this big light.
Prichádza také obrovské svetlo.
I think it would be like living that, but 100 times worse.
A ja si myslím, že pre nich to bolo niečo také, že si zažili toto, ale o 100 krát horšie.
These guys are probably freaking out, right?
Že títo chalani sú úplne v panike.
No way to understand what is going on, really.
Ani nemali poňatie, ani nedokázali chápať, že čo sa tam odohrávalo v tej chvíli.
In verse 10, we see the angel says, don't be afraid.
V 10. verši im anjel povedal, nebojte sa.
That's kind of standard angel greeting, don't be afraid.
To je také štandardné pozdravenie od anjelov, nebojte sa.
Because they are very afraid.
Lebo sa veľmi báli.
But we see what he says next, and this is the beautiful thing.
Ale vidíme, že čo im hovorí potom, a toto je tá krásna vec.
He says, don't be afraid, and this is why you don't need to be afraid.
Nebojte sa, toto je dôvod, prečo sa nemusíte báť.
I'm bringing you good news.
Veď zvestujem vám veľkú radosť.
Beautiful news.
Úžasnú novinku.
That's going to cause a great joy for everybody.
Ktorá bude všetkému ľudu.
Today in the town of David a savior has been born.
Lebo narodil sa vám dnes v meste Dávidovom spasiteľ.
He is the Messiah, the Lord.
Ktorý je Kristus, Pán alebo Mesiáš.
And this will be a sign to you, you'll find the baby, he's wrapped in cloths, he's laying in a manger.
A toto vám bude znamením, nájdete nemluvňatko obvinuté plienkami ležať v jasliach.
In verse 13, suddenly a great company of angel host appeared with the angel praising God and singing glory to God in the highest heaven and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests.
A hneď s anielom sa zjavilo množstvo rytierstva nebeského, ktorí chválili Boha a volali sláva na výsostiach Bohu a na zemi pokoj ľuďom dobrej vôle alebo pokoj ľuďom, ktorých má Boh za zaľúbenie.
But notice from this story.
Všimnite si v tomto príbehu.
These guys are freaking out.
Títo chalani, títo muži sú úplne v panike.
But what brings them comfort? What brings them shalom? What brings them peace?
Ale čo ich tak utvrdzuje, čo ich upokojuje, čo im dáva šalom?
That this prophecy of Messiah was coming true.
Že toto proroctvo o Mesiášovi sa naplňalo.
That was what the angel gave to comfort them.
Toto bolo to, čo im anjel dal, aby ich potešil.
Don't worry.
Nebojte sa.
Messiah is on the edge. He's almost here.
Mesiáš je tu.
It's great news.
Je to úžasná správa.
It's joyful news.
Je to radosná správa.
Don't be afraid.
Nemusíte sa báť.
And I like how the angel says born unto you.
A mne sa páči, ako je to tam napísané, že sa vám narodil.
Born unto you is Messiah.
Vám sa narodil tento Mesiáš.
I don't know about you, but sometimes when we talk about, you know, Jesus coming for the world, you know.
A neviem ako vy, ale my keď niekedy hovoríme o Pánovi Ježišovi, že sa narodil pre svet.
And it's completely true. He came for all of us.
A je to úplná pravda, že prišiel pre všetkých nás.
But he's born unto you.
Ale narodil sa pre teba.
He's born unto you individually.
Pre teba ako jednotlivca.
Just for you as well.
Hlavne pre teba, alebo aj teda pre teba.
You're not just a number, one of billions, okay?
A nie si len nejakým číslom, nejakým jedným z bilióna.
He is Emmanuel, God.
On je Immanuel, Boh je s nami.
You know, he is with us.
On je s nami.
I was just thinking about, you know, these famous verses that we say all the time.
A som sa zamýšľala nad týmito známymi veršami, ktoré neustále opakujeme.
I think we even read them last week.
A myslím, že aj minulý týždeň sme si ich čítali.
You know, John 3:16 and 17.
Jan 3:16 a 17.
But you know, for God so loved the world, right?
Že Pán Boh miloval tak svet.
You know, that he gave his only son.
Že dal svojho jediného syna.
Now, I want to read those verses a little bit differently for you now.
Ale teraz by som vám ich chcel prečítať inak tieto verše.
Not in a world way, but in a personal way.
Nie zo svetského pohľadu, ale z osobného pohľadu.
Actually, if you want, you can read it with me.
A ak by ste chceli, môžete si to prečítať so mnou.
For God so loved me.
Lebo tak Boh miloval mňa.
God so loved me.
On tak miloval mňa.
That he gave me his one and only son.
Že on dal mne svojho jediného syna.
That if I believe in him.
Lebo ak ja v neho budem veriť,
I will not perish.
Ja nezahyniem.
I will have eternal life.
Ja budem mať večný život.
For God did not send his son to me to condemn me.
Lebo Boh neposlal svojho syna pre mňa, aby ma odsúdil.
But to save me through him.
Ale aby ma zachránil skrze neho.
And remember that this year.
Tento rok si to pripomínajte.
Get personal with Jesus.
Majte osobný vzťah s Ježišom.
Because he's born unto you.
Lebo on sa narodil pre teba.
He's not just born theoretically for all of us, but he's born in for us individually.
Nie, že sa narodil len pre všetkých, ale narodil sa pre každého jedného z nás ako jednotlivcov.
It's personal for him.
Pre neho je to osobné.
Verse 12 says, this will be a sign for you.
12. verš nám hovorí, že toto vám bude znamením.
I don't know about you, but sometimes we all need signs.
Neviem ako vy, ale častokrát potrebujeme určité znamenia.
You know, I shared the story about this building.
A hovoril som vám už príbeh o tejto budove.
You know, the sign for me was that adding that little part of the prayer of can you give it for free?
Pre mňa to znamenie bolo, keď sme sa modlili, tak som tam pridal to, že dobre Pane Bože, ale nech je to zadarmo.
Because I know that that will only happen if God does it.
Lebo vtedy som si uvedomoval, alebo som si bol istý tým, že sa to udeje, len keď by to Pán Boh chcel.
No one here in Bratislava is that generous. So sorry.
Nikto tu v Bratislave nie je tak štedrý, žiaľ.
People are nice. They're just not that nice, okay?
Ľudia sú milí, zlatí, ale nie až takto.
Right? God has to move a heart for that to happen.
A Pán Boh musí posunúť a pohnúť nejaké srdce, aby sa to mohlo udiať.
We all need signs sometimes.
A každý z nás potrebujeme nejaké znamenie.
I don't think it's bad necessary to ask for a sign.
A nemyslím si, že je zlé si vyžiadať nejaké znamenie.
Just be smart when God gives it to go with it, you know?
Ale buďte taký chytrí, že Pán Boh, keď vám dá to znamenie, tak ho aj vidíte a nasledujte ho.
Sometimes the signs push us and give that us that little nudge that we need.
Lebo niekedy toto znamenie nám dá také posunutie, taký výstrel, čo potrebujeme.
Gives us a little confidence that we didn't have before.
A dá nám to také uistenie, čo sme možno predtým nemali.
That little nudge to believe, to really believe.
A také štuchnutie, aby sme skutočne verili.
And we see these guys, this sign gives them that nudge.
A pre týchto pastierov toto znamenie bolo takéto štuchnutie.
In verse 15 to 20 to the end there.
A od 15. po koniec tejto pasáže.
You know, they said immediately, let's go.
A oni povedali, že teda poďme.
Let's get down to Bethlehem.
Poďme do Betlehema.
Let's see this thing that has happened. Let's see what God is doing.
A pozrime sa, čo sa to stalo, čo Boh tam robil.
He's told us about it. Let's go see it now.
On nám to oznámil, tak teraz sa poďme na to pozrieť.
It says they hurried off, they found Mary and Joseph and the baby.
A je tam napísané, že sa poponáhľali, teda našli Máriu i Jozefa.
He's lying in that manger.
A našli aj nemluviatko uložené v jasliach.
He's probably in an area that they knew very, very well.
Bol pravdepodobne na mieste, ktoré dosť dobre poznali.
Right, they wanted to go and let's not just hear about the Lord, let's go experience the Lord.
A nebolo to len také, že dobre, poďme si počúvať o Bohu, ale poďme ho vidieť, poďme ho zakúšať.
Let's go see Messiah tonight.
A poďme vidieť Mesiáša dnes večer.
Right? And this prophecy,
toto proroctvo,
it didn't just prepare them to receive Jesus.
Nebolo len také, že ich to pripravilo, aby mohli vidieť Pána Ježiša.
And it didn't just give them peace when they're out in the field and it was going all crazy.
A nedalo im to pokoj, keď boli tam na tom poli a všetko to bolo také divoké okolo nich.
But it erupts in praise.
Ale toto prepukne do chvály.
Says they see Jesus, they see Messiah.
Lebo keď videli Pána Ježiša, keď videli Mesiáša.
And then they go out and they tell everyone else about him.
Čiže keď to videli, vyrozprávali, čo im bolo povedané o dieťatku.
And then the whole town's amazed.
A všetci, celé mesto, keď to počuli, sa divili tomu.
And then we see in verse 20 that they go back to work.
A 20. verši vidíme, že sa vrátili naspäť do práce.
But they go back to work differently.
Ale vrátili sa naspäť do práce zmenení.
They're back at work and they're praising God.
Lebo keď boli naspäť pri tej svojej práci, tak chválili Boha.
They're glorifying God.
A oslavovali a chválili Boha.
All the things that they'd seen and they'd heard.
Za všetko, čo počuli a videli.
And look at the very last line, which were just as they had been told.
Ako im bolo povedané.
Things that were fulfilled.
A tak ako boli tie veci splnené.
So I mean it wasn't they didn't have to wait long, you know, they got the prophecy and it fulfilled quite quickly.
A oni nemuseli čakať dlho, hej, že bolo im to proroctvo povedané, potom išli, videli ho a naplnilo sa im.
But they could look back on that and say, wow, God, you did it.
Ale keď sa na to spätne pozreli, tak si uvedomovali, že áno, Pane Bože, ty si ten, ktorý to splnil.
Amazing, you did exactly what you said you were going to do.
Úžasné, ty si splnil to, čo si predpovedal, že spravíš.
We're going to end real quick.
Skončíme.
You know, but just what do we take home? You know?
A čo si môžeme z tohto zobrať domov?
You know, I would just encourage you, be open to the Spirit speaking to you.
Tak by som vás chcel pozbúdiť, aby ste boli otvorení, keď k vám prehovára Duch Svätý.
Be open to prophecy.
Buďte otvorení na proroctvá.
Because it will lead you to glorifying God.
Lebo vás to bude viesť do toho, aby ste uctievali a oslavovali Boha.
You know, declaring good news.
Aby ste prehlasovali dobrú správu.
It'll put a confidence in you that didn't have before.
Uistí vás to a dá vám to takú dôveru, ktorú ste predtým nemali.
It'll strengthen you.
Posilní vás to. Pozbudí vás to. A uteší vás to.
It'll prepare you for things.
Pripraví vás to na nejaké veci.
It'll bring you peace.
Dá vám to pokoj.
You know, it's good.
Je to všetko dobré.
Don't have to be scared of it.
Nemusíte sa toho báť.
I want to share one more thing.
Jednu vec by som sa s vami ešte chcel podeliť. Ešte jednu vec si môžete zobrať domov.
Now, I said there's about 340-ish prophecies.
Povedal som, že je zhruba 340 niekoľko proroctiev.
About Messiah's coming.
O Mesiášovi, keď mal prísť.
But guess what? There's a lot of prophecies also about his second coming.
Ale ak ste si ešte neuvedomili, tak je veľa proroctiev aj o jeho druhom príchode.
There's a lot of them, right?
A je ich veľa.
And sometimes we kind of don't want to go too deep in that.
A niekedy my nechceme sa veľmi vhlbiť do tohto.
Because we're on the front end of it.
Lebo sme ešte len na začiatku toho proroctva.
And we don't always understand how is he going to really work this out.
A nechápame to, že ako to všetko bude fungovať, ako to Pán Boh splní.
And some of it seems a little scary.
A niečo z toho sa nám zdá aj trošku také strašidelné.
And it's definitely in one way unclear.
A nejakými spôsobmi ani nám to nie je jasné.
And you know what? I never see in the scriptures we're ever called to you know, we're not called to be afraid of Jesus' second coming.
Nikde v písme nám nie je povedané, že sa máme obávať druhého príchodu Pána Ježiša.
If we're in Jesus, we're never called to be afraid of his second coming.
Ak sme už Pánovi Ježišovi, tak sa nemusíme obávať jeho druhého príchodu.
But we are called to be ready.
Ale sme povolaní do toho, aby sme boli pripravení.
We are called to be prepared.
Aby sme boli prichystaní.
And that's what prophecy does for us.
A toto je niečo, čo proroctvo pre nás robí.
You know, all these prophecies about the second coming.
Všetky proroctva, čo sa týkajú jeho druhého príchodu.
They're there because God wants to show us what he's doing.
Sú tam na to, aby nám ukázali to, čo
begin to see it happen.
A keď to uvidíme, ako sa to bude diať,
we can be ready.
Aby sme boli pripravení.
We can be at peace.
Aby sme mali pokoj.
And we can be rejoicing. Yes, God, you're doing it.
A aby sme sa tešili na to, že áno, Pane, že už to teraz konáš.
You know, I think we could almost have that same angelic message come to us.
A myslím si, že možno také anielské posolstvo by k nám mohlo prísť.
You know, concerning the second coming.
Čo sa týka tohto druhého príchodu.
Yeah, don't be afraid.
Nebojte sa.
Messiah is coming.
Mesiáš prichádza.
This is good news.
Toto je dobrá správa.
This is joyful.
Je to, má vám to priniesť radosť.
You know, be ready.
Buďte pripravení.
Receive.
Prijmite to.
So, one last, very last thing.
Posledná teda vec.
You know, we're on the edge of a new year.
Sme na pokraji teda starého a nového roka.
Go in confidence in the new year.
Choďte s takou dôverou do toho nového roka.
Step forward.
Vykročte.
Because God has amazing things.
Lebo Pán Boh má úžasné veci.
You know, embrace those things.
Prijmite tie veci.
His heart for you is really, really good.
A jeho srdce voči tebe je zamerané veľmi dobre.
You know, and he will begin as you step forward, he'll begin to reveal those things in greater and greater measures.
A ty ako vykročíš dôvere v neho, tak on ti začne odhaľovať všetky tie ďalšie veci.
You don't have to be afraid.
Nemusíš sa báť.
You can be joyful.
Môžeš sa tešiť.
You can enjoy what's coming. Yeah?
Tešiť sa na to, čo príde.
So, let's do this. I'm going to pray.
Ja sa teraz pomodlím.
I think we're going to have at least one more song of worship.
Potom ešte budeme mať nejaké chvály.
During this time, I just encourage you, you know, maybe the Lord's spoken to you something here. I don't know.
A počas buď tých chvál, alebo potom po modlitbách, možno ti Pán Boh niečo povedal, prehovoril k tebe.
Maybe you've been holding on to something.
Možno niečoho si sa pridržal.
Something because you're afraid.
Lebo sa bojíš.
And you don't want to let go of that thing. You want to take control of that thing.
A nechceš vypustiť tú vec, chceš ju kontrolovať, chceš sa jej pridržať.
Maybe you just need to let it go. I know you just said that. You just let those things go.
Tak to pusti, nechaj to.
And say, Lord, I'm giving you this part.
A povieš, dobre Pane Bože, odovzdávam ti aj túto časť.
I don't want to control anymore in 2020.
Nechcem už kontrolovať túto vec, ovládať túto vec.
I want to give you space to do the amazing.
V tomto roku 2020 ja očakávam, že ty budeš konať úžasné veci.
Also, we have the elements of communion.
Takisto, ak ste ešte nestihli prijať večeru Pánovu, vzadu je.
These things that Jesus told us, you know, to take the bread and take the wine.
Ako nám Pán Ježiš povedal, aby sme prijímali aj chlieb, aj víno.
You know, and do it in remembrance of the sacrifice he's given us.
A aby sme to robili s tým, že si budeme pripomínať tú obeť, ktorú on pre nás vykonal.
Tells us to do it often.
Hovorí nám, že to máme robiť často.
So if it's on your heart, just go back, take it on your own.
A tak ak to máš na srdci, tak choď, príjmi to.
Receive it well.
Príjmi to správne.
Let's pray.
Pomodlíme sa.
Lord, we just thank you that your love endures forever.
Pane, my ti ďakujeme za to, že tvoja láska trvá večne.
Lord, you're good and your love endures forever.
Že ty si dobrý a tvoja láska, tvoja milosť trvá večne.
Lord, you were good then, you're good now, you'll be good tomorrow and forevermore.
Pane, ty si bol dobrý vtedy, si dobrý teraz a budeš dobrý aj zajtra, aj na veky.
Lord, you're the kind of person we can have a confidence in.
A ty si taká osoba, ktorej môžeme dôverovať.
Lord, we don't need to second guess you.
Nemusíme o tebe pochybovať.
Lord, help us to just be your people this morning.
Pane, tak nám pomôž, aby sme boli tvojim ľuďom tohto do obedia.
Be your people in this next year.
Aby sme boli tvojim ľuďom aj tento ďalší rok.
Lord, that we would just follow you.
Aby sme boli tí, ktorí ťa budú nasledovať.
That we would welcome your kingdom come.
Aby sme vítali to tvoje kráľovstvo, ktoré prichádza.
We'd welcome your will done on earth as it is in heaven.
Aby sme vítali tú tvoju vôľu, ktorá sa bude diať tu na zemi, tak ako sa deje v nebi.
Lord, we thank you that you've not left us as orphans.
Pane, my ti ďakujeme za to, že si nás nezanechal ako siroty.
Lord, you remind us of the things you've spoken about by your spirit.
A pripomínaš nám všetky tie veci, ktoré si hovoril skrze svojho Ducha Svätého.
And you give us a glimpse into what you have by your spirit.
A dávaš nám aj taký náhľad na to, čo si pre nás pripravil skrze svojho ducha.
So we invite you and we invite your spirit to just speak to us more and more each day.
A tak pozývame ťa, Duchu Svätý, aby ty si k nám prehováral viac a viac každý jeden deň.
Forgive us for being arrogant and not listening.
A tak nám odpusť, keď sme ťa ignorovali a nechceli sme ťa počúvať.
Lord, help us to be the year that we listen to you.
Tak nám pomôž, Pane, aby tento ďalší rok bol rokom, kedy ťa budeme počúvať.
We listen and we obey and we move forward.
Aby sme boli poslušní a aby sme išli za Tebou a nasledovali ťa.
We love you, Lord.
Pane, milujeme ťa.
In your great name.
Tvojom úžasnom mene. Amen.